Hello everyone, welcome to Adruth Studio, and here I am Anuja, and today we will be doing our Patachitra workshop. So we are on our day 6 and we have covered a lot many things. Today we will be doing the full standing figure of a female. How will that be? What are the proportions and how is the movement of the body, the curves and the mudras? So if you all can hear me, please type a yes so that I can get started with the session today. Hello everyone. Thank you so much. Thank you, Geeta ji. So, am I audible? Just waiting for a yes, if in case, then we'll start. So we have already done, okay, thank you, great Hirupa. Okay, I got a confirmation. It's all audible. So we will just get started. And yes, yesterday we did a sitting posture, how to do make a sitting posture. Sitting posture is also not only one type. There are many types of sitting postures. We'll do with we'll learn about that as well. Now today I will fix it on the paper here, on the station here. And what all we need today is just a pencil, eraser, a ruler, scale, whatever you call, and a drawing pen. That is a waterproof pen because I will be using the paints later on. Now those who were with me yesterday, that means in the workshop day 5, we made a beautiful painting, and some of it was the drawing was still there, and now this is a version of how it looks when it is colored. So there I will be uploading the tutorial of how to keep things in mind when we are coloring it, and then we will you can have the coloring tutorial as well. So this was a sitting posture that we did, but this is not the only posture we do. We do a lot of postures in sitting. We will deal with them one by one. So this was a beautiful picture and we painted it. I will be sharing a tutorial of this with you. Now today, to start with, it's very important in Patachitra that it has a border. So I will just make the outline for the border. You may take as big as you want. The thickness of the border is your wish, and there may be one border or two borders also. There are many pictures where we see double borders as well. So just making a border on all the four sides. I'll give it some thickness. And this is what I will be doing later. Those who have not watched my tutorial on how to do the borders may watch that, so that things will get easy. And you can choose from any border, any color that you wish for your painting. So it's not important which, whatever I choose, it is important for you to do. No, not at all. There I have given you a lot many options to do there. Now, thank you so much, Mehak. Thank you everyone. And good afternoon. So many good afternoons. Thank you so much. And yeah, the journey is nice. So let's get started with another one here. Now this is basically the size of our paper, and if I just imagine where I will be placing my figure, I will be making a standing figure, and some portion on the top and some portion on the bottom I will leave. So that brings me to this span. I have only this area to do my figure. It gives a better visual if a little up and the down is left and the whole figure is placed in the middle. So how to start with? These Patachitra pictures are not very straight. They are curved. And so I'm starting from here and I'll be ending here. This is my rough area where I will be doing it. I'll just lift it up so that you can get the whole idea. Yeah. So this is my area where I will be doing it. I will do the face and the whole thing will be divided into 7 equal parts. No, I'm not making the goddess, I'm just making a female figure, how it's standing. That can be Radha, that can be all the dancers, that can be anybody. Generally, when we make goddesses, they are sitting straight in their mudra, right? So not much mobility, like you want them to be stated at one place where you can pray. So this is not a goddess, but yes, it is just a normal lady. You can have few changes in it and make it into whatever posture you want it to be. So here, this is a one, and here I will be doing the face. For face, I want the face to be a little tilted downwards, and I'm making that circle over here. To make a perfect circle, it's not important for you to do it very dark right now. Just start hovering it on, and then you just make a couple of circles and you will just reach to a good circle. You may or may not be perfect on it, that's okay. Then I will be giving the shape of the body. So taking the shoulders here, giving it a side twist for the body here, and then straight. So I have made just a mannequin style of body structure. How would you define that? How would you decide what will you make? Just the face, then the body is generally two head size, so two units, and then the this is the one unit, that is the head, then this is till the chest, this is the navel part, this is the abdomen area, and therefore you go for the leg. So here, and after this, it's important for us to do the limbs or the hands. So here I'm making one over here, and then I will be making one over here, like this. So this is the structure of my picture. So I'm not doing any final thing right now. I'll just give it a little shape, and this, as you can see, it's very rough, and we are not going to trace the lines, because as if you see the plotting of the picture, there is not one line, there are many lines that I'm doing, and just giving a very rough picture. So this is not at all final one. And yeah, that's pretty much what I have to do. Now I will start with the pen. So what I'm using here is a pen which is a Uniball eye. I generally use this pen, probably it's just lying on my table, and it's waterproof, it's good, and it lasts long. So it has a big tank, so it's not a sponsored anything, but this is my pen that I use if in case I have to do the waterproof do it with a waterproof pen. I also use Microns, but of lately with the Pattachitra I'm using this because it has slightly thicker tip and give bolder lines. So I will be starting with the face, putting it down for the view. Yeah. So since my face is this side, it's facing downwards, it's a slightly tilted face, a very pointed nose, lip. I have given a tutorial on how to make these Pattachitra faces. Those who have not viewed, please view it, so the this type of faces will come very easy for you. Yesterday also we did the same kind of a face. This is the band here, ear. Thank you. earring. Going on to the head, here also you can add elaborate jewelry also. This is one thing which is very common. I'm adding the jura. Whenever we make jura, at times it is placed a little up or down. Visually it will look very nice if you check it by the nose, ear, and then so lower the bun and it will look very pleasant. So if at all you want to make a high bun, that is your wish. Otherwise, on the neck. This is the neck, the bands coming to one shoulder here. Going on to the next one, like this. Taking the center of the body, you have to plan the center of the body. So if I see that this is my body, the center of the body is also going like this. So then all my jewelry will have to go in the same. So it is falling in the center. So we'll not make it in the side or up front. It is a three, it is a side face, but the figure is standing straight here. I'm making the chest and this is the next band. You can add two or three bands depending on what all jewelry you want to put. So I've made till here. The reason why I do the rough sketch first is I get to know what I have to add and where I have to add. So if at all there is some overlap, I know which place to hide. So here is the hand and it is getting hidden by the chest. Now this curve is very important. Plan out the jewelry and then give the, here the detailings can be added as tassels or whatever. The dress needs to be added, the drape of the sari. So this, when we make this, the curve is very soft and brings down a lot of beautiful femininity to the figure. Making the hand. So this part is never straight, it is a little bent because we have more flesh over here. You can add the jewelry of a ring or whatever you want. Now going on the other side, if I want to give some something in the hand, probably yesterday we did the pot, and if in case I want to add a pot, I will add it like here. So first make the pot, so that you do not fall on the wrong proportion. And now we will start with the hand. So we'll get the whole idea about it, how it will be. Check the length where your band is coming on the other hand and see to it that it's symmetrical, the sleeve of it. Now, here is the hand over the matka or the pot here. like this. Now, since it is, the hand has to be around the pot, like this, and I can add the pot. Now, when you give something, you will always see that some part of the waist is hidden, and that is okay. Definitely it will hide because it is coming over it. Now adding the sari, the drape. This is a very peculiar kind of a dressing that is there. The sari gets wrapped up on the chest, and the same thing goes around the waist. It also has a pallu, which we will do. So for the waistband, so this line is going straight, very straight. The drape of the sari I'm making. Now coming to the foot part, how to make the foot of the lady and how, where to make it. So when you look at your proportions, you will see the head size is one unit, the same 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So I will 7.5 I will take, and then I will make the foot. How would you know how, which way the foot is? So we make a wedge. This is a rough thing. It's a very rough thing. So here is the wedge. You can make two of them. Like this. And now, first kada or the band I'm making here. Since this foot is on the front, I will be making this first. So here, like this. There is a small curve that we would make for the foot. Like this. Then the thumb also gets a little plump from the down. And on the top, it goes straight. So this is how we make the foot. Now, I will be adding the heel. The same way I'll be doing on the other side. Definitely it is getting hidden, so whatever is the hidden part we won't do, like this. So this is another foot. So this is the dress and this is the lady here. We'll start finishing it, the whole form. Now, we can add some designs, like if in case it is ornamented or wearing a lot of jewelry. This kind of tassels and dangling is very common, and it's a very distinctive feature. So if you happen to see any of such, you will know that, okay, with the style of it, you can discriminate between the various forms. Thank you so much. Thank you, Rupa. Okay, so this here, now I am going to do the detailing from one side. So the first thing that I will be doing is I have a lot of lines that I did explaining the form, and I will be erasing all of them. Here. Now I'll go ahead and do the face first, starting from the top. We can do it. Now where to place the eye? Where the nose is starting, we'll place the eyebrow. I'm making a little thin and the long eye. Like this. And a I can add the nose ring and the design. What all designs can we add for the hair is we can have these the designs on the jula. Here also we can add those beautiful parsley shapes. So this will look like more jewelry is on there. Now I'm not doing all the detailing with my pen here. You can also make use of colored pens while you want to do the detail work. I'll show you about how to use. Now what I have is a Pentel. It's just colorful pens. You get it. These are jelly pens. They are not waterproof, but these are 0.7 tip and they are beautiful colors. So if at all you want to color it and then over that you want to do the design, you can make use of such pens. I'll show you how we can do that. The same design, but if in case a different color, then it adds a lot more beauty to it. So if you're liking the video, if you're liking this, please press the like so that I get to know. Okay, Bhavna, yes. Any doubts? My paper that I'm using is a 200 GSM. I use this standard paper for works. If in case it is not very heavy on water, then I will take a 200. If in case too much of paint, then I will take a 300 GSM. That's what I generally take. Adding borders here. You can do any elaborate design that you want. Now on the pot also, see to it that the designs will not be geometrical, they'll be more curvier, and few of the border designs we can add in here. Since I would keep this plain because the hand is coming, if too much of focus is on the pot, the beauty of the hand will not be highlighted. So those are a few things that we may keep in mind. So these are overlapping parsley shape, and this is a very commonly seen design in the Pattachitra. Yeah, I'll lower it down so that it's visible better. Now, since the dupatta is over here, sari, we will just make the extension of this. This has to be a little flowy and beautiful, and it will start thin and it will go broad. The same design I'm adding on the other side of it. This is one picture of a standing figure. I'm adding the ground here. Like this. We'll go ahead and we'll color it. Just a double outline to separate it from the background. I'll just go through the chats. If in case you are having any doubts, please write it. Ma'am, I have these. Okay, very good. Yes, we might do a little bit of detailing. The color, we won't be able to do the full of the coloring. Any doubts on pen, paper, style, or anything? Initially, these were not done on the paper, on paper and with these pens. So it was done with the pigment of the stone colors. So these stone colors were taken from the earth. Earth means the different color of stones were there. They were grinded, they were powdered, and they were mixed with Arabic gum. And then it is authentically, it was done like that. But now today, we are just recreating the same kind of image on paper with pens. Pattachitra and Kalamkari. The whole, what is the difference between? I hope you've seen the Kalamkari. Kalamkari figures are not this way. They are not that bent mostly, you will see. The face is totally different. The embellishments are totally different. They have a different distinctive feature on that. So it's not that the subject, where they come together is the subject. So the subject is mainly gods and goddesses. Somewhere we see a lot of motives in Patachitra. We do not see a lot of motives. It's basically focusing on the figures. Whereas in Kalamkari, we see peacock, Buddha, lots and lots of motives of animals and birds also, which is not very common in Patachitra. Patachitra is basically the gods, goddesses, and the social, this humans are also there doing their routines sometimes. You can buy Brustro if in case in India we get Brustro. That is a good quality paper. Yes, yes. We will do the male figures. This is a question that body curves are there for males also. Yes, they are there. We will do Krishna and you will see how it is. That is going to be the male study will be, is our next topic for the next week. We will do that as well. So you will see how we make the Shiva and Krishna. You will see distinctive feature, and not one body type is same for all. So we see few manly figures. When we do the Shiva, we do manly look of him, and when we do Krishna, it's more subtle. So we will do that as well. So let's, yes, we can also get started with the paints as well. So let me just put the paints and I'll show you a few tricks how to do that. So what color goes for the face is yellow. It's just plain yellow. That is for the females. If we also see some pink shades, very rarely, but for females. For males, we have a CADA, we have a code for those. Like for Ram, we do green. For Krishna, we do blue. And at some places, we see Krishna in black also. So, but if we are doing Ram, it has to be light green in color. Shiva and Krishna are blue in color. Any demons can be pink or dark green. So we also see the figures with white faces if you are doing the goddesses. Sometimes if it's a monochromic, nothing is, no color is added, and it is only the black and white, or any one color is taken. Now I'll start with the paint here, and for the face I'm taking the chrome yellow, sorry, golden yellow. It's good, golden yellow here. For thinner areas, you will use thin brushes. What I am using is a synthetic brush. Now, I've received questions like which brands are good for the brush. I would not suggest you any one particular brand. Just see to it that your bristles are nice and in line, they are not frayed and they have a point. They are behaving in a manner where you want it to be. But yes, so I will show you what I've been using. This is a local brand, it's not even any big brand. So it is just this. If I tell you that I use this, you won't be able to find it because it's from a local art store. Whereas I use Camel, I use Faber-Castell, and they are also very good. So if you want to buy it, then you can go with those brands. Now just, I'm using the bottle colors. If you are using the tube colors, definitely they are thick and you need a little bit of more water there. So starting with the face. So see to it that when you are using, your brush doesn't have a lot of paint. It will not give you a drop right there. And just do the outline first. You will see at times, only the circle, only the raw form of it is made, where this coloring and the detailing part comes later. They do it only with pencil and then they first color. Later they will be doing this coloring and the detailing. So first putting the color, and then later when it dries, then this black outline and colorful outlines and detailing with the brush will happen. So I'm just filling up the portions of the skin. Nice yellow shade you will see for the figures, for the female figures. Very bright pictures are there. We might also find a subtle pigments. What color for Kali? Of course, black. Thank you, Anjali. Thank you so much. So here we'll see this this side is the sari and this is the waist. So here also I'm adding the body. Generally the colors on the faces and all are black, are flat. I'm so sorry, it's not black. So it's flat coloring, means there's no shading. Later on what happens is we create the highlight with white lines. Later we will be creating lot of things with the brush and the pens and other things here. So I'm done with the skin part. I hope I've not missed anywhere. Now going with the black. The hair is always black. See to it, when you are doing a fine line, you have to keep in mind that your brush doesn't bend a lot. You do not put pressure on your brush. So only the tip, only the line, if you have to draw, it has to be very lightly done, where your bristles do not fray away, they do not spread. So do not press your brush while doing the line here. Now you can actually go ahead and be a little fast in filling up the gaps. I'm doing the eyeball here. That is how the face starts to pop out really well. No, we do not use flesh tint for body. Now the dress, I can take any of the bright colors. So I'll take a okay, why don't you all tell me which color you want? So I will just do it as you say. So let me see what color you want for the dress. Any two colors to go in contrast. So let's have a poll here. And let's see, whatever you wish, like, okay, let's check this color. How does it look? Because I have not decided anything, I'll be just painting on the spot. So, if in case anybody has any idea, please write it down. Red. Okay, red and light green. Those are the two things that popped on my chat first. So, I'll take it. Okay, so red, if I take, I'll find my red. Okay. And let's get started with red. Have to mix it. Whenever you take color from directly your bottle, you will see that few of the bottles when you buy, you will see that they are very they are in good state, they are liquid. Like suppose I'll just show you what why how much you have to consistency. And this is a very old one and it's more pasty. So definitely when I take some color, I'll have to add more water on the dried one. So just add a little. And wherein you get the consistency of a nail paint, I would say, not the toothpaste, but a nail paint, that kind of a consistency. If you take it, will work good and it will not leave patches of transparent color. Patachitra, no, it's not that all the time it will be very pale. In at places we see shading also, and I will go ahead and do the shade work and I'll show you how is the shading done. So here I'm just taking my red paint and filling it. We do see shading also. It's not mandate that there has to be a shading, but there is if at all you want to do the shading, you are still okay. It's not that you are just going out of the limits and just playing around with the style too much. We do shade. So here I'm doing the red. Since it is the sari and this all is a drape, so I will just add this red color. So if you're doing a very big picture on a canvas, then you have to take the big one. The big brush. If in case you are using a thin, I mean like a smaller picture, then you have to go for a thin brush. So it's the flat color over here. Just taking a little bit more. Instead of paint, what you can use pens also, brush pen also. In my yesterday's session, I showed a little bit how to do it with brush pens. So you can just check that. No, what I am using is, yes, it's Crimson 04. That's the shade of red I have. Just do the outline first so that you're comfortable filling in. So this is the drape and the sari. I'll take light green for this portion. Now, since yes, you want to check the alternate, I will show you how the alternate is and how to add the shades as well. So the alternate for any of the paint is just the brush pens that you have. So how you can work on this is, when you are doing it, always do it in the motion where you want the flow to be. So if in case you are getting those lines, then you are happy with those lines also. So just go one side because that is the fold of the dress. So this here, and I can add the same color on this side. You might get the brush lines also. You might get, if in case your pen gets doubled, if you just rub your brush two times over one area, you will get the lines. Now, how much shade do we have to add? So it's still wet here. It is mixing on the wet side already, and this is how I can just add a little bit of shade. But that has to be settled down with the print on the dress. We also add a little bit of shading with the pen, with the white color highlights. I'll give the same combination for this. Now I'll wait for a while for it to dry so that I can work with the pen on top. Now on the red, what all I can do for giving the shade is, it's minimum. You can only add one or two lines to enhance your shade work. Here I have the similar shade in maroon, and I will be using this maroon to do the darker areas. Only this line is enough to create that. No, it's only generally the dark and light. We do not do two different colors. If at all you want to make a mixed shade, you can just create a shade of brown or something. But With this, it is going to be only one color, but color is one. You can create a light and a dark shade. That's all you can do. Now, how to create the overall work look? I will show you. I'll place it down so that it's a little detailed for you to see. If I want to create the full working on the dress, this goes freehand. So you can, if you're not comfortable making these patterns, or you're not, you can also draw it with pencil if in case you want, first over the paint and then try to do this. But if not, you can also add prints, small flowers or other things. I'll show you in another area about that kind of prints. So this is a full heavy work that is there, and how to highlight this work. So here I'm just creating with the similar color, a little darker shade, so it's not very obvious, but in a while it will be. Just going ahead with the full run through of the dress. Yeah, just giving it the same. You may not be very calculative. Do not put into account how many curves you're making, which way you're making. It's a freehand thing. And do it with only brush. Do not use pen. Otherwise, it will be very bold. You will not have that kind of effect. So, ideally, I'm just showing you different ways of how you can work on it with different mediums depending on your comfort level. But ideally, I vouch for a brush. This is always better. Can we use color pencil? No, color pencils won't really be very obvious over the paint. So color pencils are very subtle that way. So I'm just making those curves. Parsley shape, you can make circles, you can make anything simple. Just go a little loose on the shapes. Do not try to make them all with harsh lines. Do not make them all with harsh lines. So that's what I am trying to create here. So with the brush, you will actually have them as a stroke work. So your lines will be bolder at one place and they will thin down at the end. Whereas with pen, it is very difficult to control that. So this is the full look of it. Now I'll just show you how to highlight those areas. This has dried a little and I will show you. You can also use a different color jelly roll pen. So if in case you want to use an orange or a yellow, you can use that as well. It's not very important that it has to be white all the time. So this is how we are just creating. And when you put this pen, you feel that it's more white. After it dries, it will be a little subtle as well. Only on the curved side, I'm doing those small curves. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much. I'm glad you all are liking it. So it takes a little bit time and patience, but yeah, we don't have any rush to do it. Yeah, like so. Now, it is not always important for us to do this. We can also create different color designs. So here with other pens as well. So here I have a, let me see if it's dried and I can work on it. Yes. So here I can make only line pattern, that is also good. So this is also very commonly seen, and it is, and when you do this pattern, the lines, somebody was asking, right, the lines, what if the lines come with the print over it? It won't be that obvious. Of course, we don't have to we have to try that we do not make lines and the lines don't appear, but if at all it is, we can just check on this. Like this. So this is there. The same way we can do on the sari over here. So if in case you want to do the lines, good enough. If in case you do not want to do the lines, then what? Then you can add those flowers. Now, I would prefer doing this with the brush and this. I'll show you some design on the pen tail. I'm just making those circles here. So it's a different darker color. It is blue color. And if you do blue over green, it will not shine out blue as much. So here are the few. I'll just so with a thin lining, you can make the dots. Thin liner brush. When you are making dots, do not make your paint so runny. Yes, it does. So and moreover, we have not yet done the jewelry. It will brighten up even more. So we'll just finish all of it today. So you'll get the full idea of how to do the. So paint, anytime you see paint is more bright. So do not make use of those dotting tools or anything. I mean, like, nobody stops you from that if you, in case you want to do it, but try doing it with brush, it comes beautiful. You'll have to pick your paint many times since you are doing the dot. You will see that they're getting transparent, and then you need to reload your brush. And in the center, do a white. So this way you can create print also. If you are not comfortable doing the overall thing, then you can work on that. And now we will go on to the jewelry and the matka. So those are the two things that are left for us. And I will take some color which is lighter and brighter. So here I have a brush pen. Here I'll go with the brush pen. I'll see. I'm covering the whole of it, the full thing here and here. And then once your brush pen is wet and still you do it, it bleeds on the other side and it gives a beautiful blend. So this gets blended up automatically. I just made two lines. You don't have to be very specific about this. It will blend automatically. And then a little bit of one line of dark pink. It will bleed in a manner where the shapes will be created. You don't have to worry about. So that way you can create this kind of a shade work. Filling the inside of it. Again, doing it the same way, this side from the sides. So the blending can be done with this as well. So it's not that it's not. You may add the design, you may just do it flat, your wish. Now we'll go to the jewelry part. When we do the jewelry part, it's our wish whether we want it colored or not. Sometimes with the ladies wearing this kind of a jewelry, it gets tricky because this jewelry is yellow and the body is yellow. How to differentiate between the two and keep them all aside? We take help from this orange. Let's see where the orange is. So here I have orange and a very thin lining brush. Dilute it a little so that you don't get big blobs of paint. So now the consistency is a little milky consistency is here, and now for that I will be adding the orange. One side I'm adding only the ends. So I'm leaving a little bit of white as well. So it is not always important for us to do the full jewelry part. So I'm just doing half of it and that's good. I'll make use of different color pens to create the effect. So here it is. Just a little hint of color will be good enough. So I'm adding this big broad band. So this with the colors. I can add the tassels. These tassels can be any color. If they can be red, they can be black. That is a little infringement that's there. Thank you, Jyoti. And here, just the tassels. As I told in my previous class also, in those days the jewelry was all tied up, so it had strings. Today also we have few of those which are tied. They have those strings. You may also use, if in case you are not very comfortable with the brush directly doing this, then you can use the pen. So these here, and yes, if you're liking the video, press the like. Thank you so much. Yes, it's beautiful. I really love too much of ornamentation, so I keep on and on with it. I'll just show you a little bit of the band which is here. This is full in orange, and I'll create the metallic kada, the big heavy kada that is worn. So here I will be using the pens now. I have this is a pink pen, any pen, red, green, pink, whatever, and I'm just doing a little bit of tapping on it, a little dotted look, so that with the red color, giving the details with red. Now, one thing is very, very commonly seen, the ends of the eyes are mostly red. So just add that little dot with red on the eye. I'll just show you here. It's not visible probably. But yes, the corners like the tear gland over here, the tear duct, that will just do red. So here, this is pretty much on this picture, and I feel that it's full and complete. Looking very beautiful. We can do a beautiful border and then we can finish off this picture. You may leave the background white also, that is also acceptable. Add a little booties or small flower prints, and that's good enough for this picture. I hope you all liked this, and if in case you enjoyed it, share it with others and help support the channel. Thank you. Thank you, Kavita. Okay, any other concerns or any other questions you might have, you may write in the comment section and I will get back to you. I'll answer all your doubts, and share the workshop with others who might be interested. That way you can support us, and I will continue to do what I do. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your time. I'll see you next week with another study on how to make the male figures, because male figures are a lot, many male figures, and not all of them are the same. So we will do Shiva and Krishna. So a little softer form and a little manly, more flamboyant form of it. So thank you all. See you next week. Bye-bye. Take care.